What's up, guys? Miticus. Who is the coach of the Charlotte Carbinks. You can see on the layout below what I'm predicting him to bring. An Excadrill, a Chiron Black, Mega Pinsir, Gigalith, Raichu, and Chesnaught. Very, very scary team, guys, that we're going to be dealing with. A lot of sand. I have brought a great team, I think, though. I don't know exactly how competitive we're going to be in this battle just because of this team. His team is nasty. It's really, really nasty. But we do have Beedrill. We have a defensive Mew. We have a specially defensive Politoed with Drizzle. We have Tapu Koko. We have a Fortress, and we have Snow Warning Ninetales with Aurora Veil. And Aurora Veil is going to be our key here. We got to get the Aurora Veil up, and we got to do well with it because it's really the only way we're going to be taking hits from things like the Chiron. From the Mega Pinsir, if he gets up a Swords Dance. Even then, I don't know if we can take any hits from it, to be honest. We gotta watch out for the spikes from the Chesnaught, if he's carrying spikes. Gotta be doing really well with getting hazards off the field, because if he starts hazard stacking us, and we don't have Fortress around to get rid of those, we're gonna be in a lot of trouble. I think I did actually stick Defog on Mew as well, just to be sure that we do have a backup. I didn't really need the extra move slot. It would have been nice to carry maybe Toxic or Will-O-Wisp on it, but I just didn't feel at the end of the day I needed that. Instead, I needed something that was there to get rid of the hazards, because I need Beedrill, I need Coco to Volt Turn. Rather, as much as possible. So it looks like I'm gonna just kind of tell him we're ready. I'm not sure if he has done his intro or not for his video, but we will return as soon as the battle is ready to go, guys. So just hang in there. All right, welcome back, guys. He did bring the sand. I didn't see the Gigalith back there. This is not the team that I expected him to bring, though it may be okay in the long run for us. We'll have to kind of play it out and see how it goes. Let me make one adjustment with our display here, just real quick. We're just going to make one quick adjustment. Shouldn't be that big of a deal. I think that's pretty good right there. Okay, so let's go ahead and change this team around. We don't see the Chiron. Instead, we see a Chandelure. So we need to be watching for a Scarf Chandelure, possibly. So there's that. We do not see a Mega Pinsir. That's pretty big for us. Instead, we see a Reuniclus. So let's see if we can get our system to load that up for us. Nice. We do see the Gigalith. We don't see the Raichu. Instead, we see a Exploud. So we really didn't get this team at all correct in prediction. But, you know, I think I prepped for as much as I could his entire team. And we actually don't see the Chespin either. We actually see Melodic. So that's also interesting as well. Let's get the Melodic in there, and we will be good to start looking at leads. I'm just going to tell him good luck, have fun. And we're going to start looking at the leads now. Wow. What do we lead? I mean, obviously we can lead a Volt Turner here. Oh gosh, I'm sorry guys, that did not work, did it? That did not work at all. That just messed up a lot of things. Okay, so Looks like we're going to be playing from the side here. So what do we want to do here? It's pretty huge for us to lead the Ninetales, I think. Our win con. To get the Aurora Bell up immediately. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And that's okay. We're actually just going to go straight into Trevor here to make sure that that sand is gone. We do not want that sand. I thought about actually leading Trevor first, but it just didn't really make a lot of sense because we could have, I guess, switched in Ninetales into a hit from this thing, but we don't want to switch Ninetales into anything that we don't need to. I think I'm running an actual fully defensive Mew, so we could switch that in. Do we think he's going to get his rocks up here? He could just get his rocks up here. So it could be a free switch in with Trevor to get Drizzle going, which I think is what we're going to do. I think he's probably going to go for an attack though, but he actually does get his rocks up. So we got in our Politoed for free. I'm actually going to send this link to everybody in our Discord lobby. That way they can see what's up. Because everybody likes to watch our games. So, what we can do here is... As you can see on the screen, I got Blizzard going. My thought process there was, oh, okay, I'll send Politoed out after the hill goes up and use Blizzard. You can't do that because I have Drizzle. That's really unfortunate. I don't know what I was thinking there. Do we think at this point the Excadrill comes out? No, probably not, right? Because he doesn't want to take a Scald or anything at this point. He probably thinks Scald's coming. So I think his prediction here is to go with the Melodic and maybe get a Toxic off on the Politoed. Or he could go into Reuniclus. Either way, I think Toxic is the right play here. So as you can see, we did pull that prediction off correctly. It wasn't a hard prediction by any means. But it does help us in the scheme of things. We are able to maybe wear down this Melodic, whereas we could not have before. I would like to get a Toxic on the Reuniclus at some point. That would be pretty huge for us. Get rid of these walls, put a timer on them, make sure that they can't just stay in and stall late game. That would be really huge for us. So at this point, we are figuring... Probably a Toxic is going to come in for himself, which is fine. Do we want to go into Solitude? The only thing is, Solitude, his special defense isn't great at all. But we are carrying Volt Switch. So we can Volt Switch out, but we would be taking two Scalds. And I'm just trying to think if that's what we want to do. In my opinion, probably what's happening here is probably a Toxic. That's what I'm thinking. But at the same time, it's really kind of hard to determine. I could go into Ninetales here. We do have Freeze Dry on it, which is pretty nice. And we have the Aurora Bell, which would be nice as well to get that up. And then if we feel like he's going to switch out his Melodic, we could also get a Toxic off on whatever comes in, maybe the Reuniclus. I think I'm just going to go Fortress here, which I don't want to do really, but I think it might be a good play because I think he's going to go for the Toxic here. He does go for the Toxic. And as you can see, we got him down 88% now. There really probably shouldn't be any reason for anything to come out except for that Gigalith to get the sand back up. So I think we're just going to volt switch. And right now it's just really, really important to start getting momentum as much as possible, because this team is really, really scary. And that Excadrill is just terrifying with the sand up. So anytime that Gigalith has the potential to come out, I need to get one of my weather setters on the field. Or I need to get them in position to come out anyway. The next time that the rocks are up, it may have been a better choice, and I can still cancel now, but I don't think I'm going to. It may actually be a better choice to rapid spin here, predicting the Gigalith to come out. And then it kind of forces him into a decision of, does he want to get the rocks back up, or does he want to go for the attack and weaken that Politoed? He actually just, okay, that's okay. We can actually send out Coco now and put a tremendous amount of pressure on him. I probably should have put Thunder on Coco now that I thought about it, because I was running Drizzle on the Politoed, but Thunderbolt's still going to hurt. It's going to hurt a good amount. We don't see the Raichu, so we are really free to click all click Thunderbolts. You know, obviously the Excadrill can come in and be an issue for us, but really, if we can get Coca-Cola, our Tapu Koko, out right now, would that be the best play for us? Or, actually, I think what the best play is to send this guy out and get the Aurora Bell up. Now I'll think about it. Now we are going to get a Toxic here. We are going to get a Toxic. So that's something to think about. Unfortunately, I really, really hate that Solitude took that much damage from the Scald. I may have overpredicted there. But it's okay. It's okay. He can still take a few hits. Especially with the Aurora Veil up. He can take a few defensive hits. But let's go ahead and get the Aurora Veil up. I do think that he might switch out here because his Melodic, or he may just recover. He's either going to switch out or recover. I don't know if he Toxic here just simply because his Melodic is getting really worn down. And I guess he can suffice one more turn, but I can freeze draw him next. I'm just going to get the Aurora Veil up. He does switch. So we got the Aurora Veil up, which is huge for us. And we can actually send out Politoed now and maybe put on some pressure. Politoed's not going to put on a tremendous amount of pressure by any means, but what Politoed can do is maybe get this Reuniclus to come in and get a Toxic off on it, which would be great. I'm expecting that he pulls a double here. I'm expecting that he pulls a double and that he goes out into his Gigalith, which is fine. That's fine. Because if he goes out into his Gigalith, I'm going to send out Politoed, and that's going to get rid of his sand immediately. And our ring will be back up. Aurora Veil will be up. And his Gigalith will have to switch out because Politoed is out. So that's what we're hoping for. That's the play that we're hoping for here. I think he's going to fill. Well, he did not switch, I don't think. Shadow Ball comes in. Special Defense drop. That's unfortunate. It's unfortunate. What we are going to do is, I think we're going to go for the Do we go for the Toxic here? I don't know if we go for the Toxic here. He may be satisfied going. I think we are going to go for the Toxic. And that's fine. That's okay. We are wearing the focus sash, so that's kind of unfortunate. It does us no good at this point. Endeavoring something would be nice. It would be nice. But it doesn't look like that strategy is going to actually happen. What I think we can do here, he's going to scald again, I think. No, he might. He's going to toxic. He's going to toxic. That's what he's going to do. Because he knows I don't want to come back and I want to scald. So, if he's going to toxic, I can send out Beedrill. And although Beedrill's going to take 25% from the rocks, we're going to absorb this toxic. Okay. That's okay. Because now we still get momentum. We still get momentum. We're just going to U-turn out. We need to get the rocks off the field, but I need to be careful. Mew does have defog, so that's something we can look at after we switch here, depending on what he does. And we're just gonna go simply for a U-turn here. This should do a decent amount. Nothing too terrible. Definitely not gonna knock him out by any means or anything like that, but we also have to look at the Aurora Veil turns. We're down to 4 turns. That's decent damage. He stayed in. So we can only assume that he either went for the recover, or he went for a scald. I think we're okay sending out Mew. Although, okay, that's okay. That's okay. How important is it for him? I think I'm just going to U-turn, but defog would be pretty decent. I think I'm going to defog. I think he might toxic, but I just think I'm just going to defog and get these rocks off the field. I need my Beedrill. I need my Coco to be able to come in and not take that damage. He may not think it is beneficial to him to let his Melodic take any more toxic damage. He may switch out. He may recover. I really, really hope that he does not toxic. That it's going to really put a limit of use on our Mew. So I really wanted to go for the U-turn there, maybe predicting him to switch, but if he doesn't switch, it kind of puts us in a tough spot. Getting those rocks off the field right now is really the most important thing for us to do. Because we have Fortress, that's a Volt Switcher, a U-turner in Beedrill, U-turner in Mew, Volt Switcher in our Tapu Koko. So it's of huge importance for us to make sure that there's no hazards on the field. That way we can continuously switch in and out and not take that continuous 12 to 25% damage. He does switch. I kind of thought he would. We are able to get the rocks off the field. So that's great for us. So we can U-turn here. We can U-turn, but I am defensive. So I could just knock off, which I think is what I'm going to do. I am defensive. I should be able to take whatever he gives and be able to recover it next turn. The scary thing here is if Extra Drill decides to come out right now. I am going to be able to knock off his item, So if he's Life Orb or Banded, that would be pretty huge for us knocking that off. But he's still gonna be he's still gonna be a, you know, really fast. So we are gonna go for the knockoff here. And you know, maybe we'll knock the leftovers if that's what he's carrying. Have we seen his item on here? No, we have not seen his item yet. So it could be really interesting to see what this Gigalith is carrying. Maybe we can see an overall strategy with this team. So yeah, he did have just a standard standard leftovers. That's fine. That's fine. We have one turn of Aurora Veil left. So it's important for us to get rid of the sand pretty soon. I'm really considering just going for a double knockoff here. Predicting that extra duel to come in because he's going to want to start putting pressure on my team. And he may think I'm just going for the defog here, which wouldn't be a bad idea. It wouldn't be a bad idea. We still have our item left over, so we're going to get a little bit of health back. I do think he's going to switch, and we can either U-turn or we can knock off. A U-turn, the issue with that is we U-turn, we switch. And so he switches an Excadrill. We U-turn the Excadrill. Excadrill has the sand. We could come in and get rid of the sand immediately. That might be an okay plan, actually. Let's do that. So we're going to do the U-turn there. And we can send out... I think we're going to send out Coco. Have the electric surge. I think he's going to predict. I think he's going to predict me to volt switch, and Excadrill is going to come out and take advantage of the sand. I think I'm just going to hit him with an HP ground. So now we have a decision to make. Definitely have a decision to make here. We did 48%. 48.2. We took some life orb damage. We took some damage coming in on the rocks. And we're looking to be at 66% now. So we got to figure out what to do. I mean, it's kind of a huge thing for it. I think he thinks we're going to switch, so he may Swords Dance. But I don't know if he can take that chance. Solitude doesn't do a lot for us at this point. I don't think Solitude does. I'm just afraid that he's going to Swords Dance. But is this the last turn of sand because he was carrying leftovers? Is that right? I think that's how that works, actually. But maybe not. Maybe sand stream lasts for 5 turns. I'm not 100% sure. It's probably something I should know. Let's send out Solitude. We're going to take some damage on the rocks and get knocked out. But let's just do it. Regardless. Right. So here's the thing. We can actually come back in and we can possibly knock out this thing with that HP ground. Or we can go into our, what does he do here? Does he go back into Gigalith? Does he go back into Gigalith, get the sand back up? It's probably best to get the rocks up, isn't it? What kind of damage are we gonna be taking from this thing? Well, let's find out. Excuse me one second, guys, as I calc this. Okay, let's see what our Mew does to this thing. We can take pretty much anything. Oops. Trying to get back to our game here. I think Mew can take anything. We're just gonna soft boil and get some health back. He might go into Gigalith. Let's see. Was I calcing for Life Orb? Yeah. He's not gonna want to. Well, he may actually want to lose his Life Orb at this point. He's getting pretty low on health. I probably should have went to Coco there. Put some pressure on. I'm at 66% with Coco, and I really want the rocks off the field because I'm taking that life orb damage. And we do have his Melodic pretty low at this point, which is nice. But if he does send in his Melodic right now, he's going to be free to recover on us. So that's kind of unfortunate. Okay. So he does choose to go ahead and send out Gigalith again. And he may just send rocks back up right when I defog him. I'm not sure. Not 100% sure what his plan is. I do know that I would love the chance to get Ninetales back out there to get another Aurora Veil out. I think that's really important. Now, I kind of want to play around with him a little bit. I kind of want to know where he's going with this. And maybe in the meantime, get a little bit of damage on this thing, wear it down a little bit. And we're just gonna soft boil. He may switch out into the Excadrill here. At this point, he more than likely knows that my Mew is a defensive Mew. He just gets the rocks back up, which is fine. I'm going to knock off here. I'm just going to continue to try to wear this thing down. Mm-hmm. Just gonna knock off again. And I'm gonna knock off again. Wearing this thing down and it has no recovery, he has no wish users. So I don't know what his plan is here exactly. I've stalled out the sand, which is great. Just, I might actually go for the defog here. There's actually no reason for me not to go to the defog. No reason. Defog is definitely the play. Defog is definitely the play. I'm thinking he's gonna switch. Because he doesn't want this thing taking, you know, more damage. It's really not necessary. It's really not necessary at all. We could see a switch here. Okay. That's kind of what I thought. I think we probably should just see the recovery here. I'm just going to U-turn. And we're going to go out into our win con here. And he will switch. He will switch into the Gigalith. Right here. He will switch into the Gigalith right here. Which is probably why we're going to go with our Beedrill. He cannot let Aurora Veil go up. There's no way he can let Aurora Veil go up. It'd be terrible on his part to let Aurora Veil go up. And if I click Aurora Veil, he's going to switch. The sand's going to come out. There's no way that happens. Right. So, is this Scarf Chandler? I really thought... I don't understand why he did that. I don't know why he wouldn't get the sand up. Okay, so if this thing is Scarf Chandler, we need to get out of here ASAP. Trevor is going to get destroyed. Actually, wait, we've seen something. Hold on. We have seen a Shadow Ball from this Chandler. It did 29% to our Trevor. We can use that to our favor. We can count to see if it's... specs or if it's Scarf. Specs Shadow Ball 39% to 47%, but that was with the Veil up, right? We had Aurora Veil up. Let me make sure. We used Aurora Veil, he used Shadow Ball because then I switched. It did 29.7%. It did 29.7%. It did 29.7%, guys. What does that mean? That means there's no way that he can be Scarfed. If he's Scarfed Modest, max attack, it's doing way less than that. There's no way he can be Scarfed. We drill run here. Yeah. Yeah, there was no way he could have been scarfed. Right? I think I caught that, right? Yeah, he did way too much damage to be scarfed. Yeah, we had that right. Okay. 258. We're at 254. I think I actually built this thing to outspeed. Scarfed X Plowed for some reason. 387. So actually, Scarfed X Plowed would outspeed me. Let's say he's not scarfed, though. Yeah. He's not scarfed. He's not scarfed. What do we do here? We're thinking he probably goes Gigalith here, I think. Let's go Trevor. Let's go Trevor. Oh, well, he's going to get to choose. Okay, so he's probably going to go, like, what, Reuniclus or Melodic? Yeah, he'll go either Reuniclus or Melodic here. No reason for him to go with anything else. Unfortunately, I think that's a misplay on my part. I should have either went... I should have went Coco. I should have Volt Switched. And if it didn't work, I just HP Ground and knock out the Drober. That was a bad play on my part. That was a bad play. Now he gets momentum back because I have to switch. That was a bad play. That was a bad play. It's okay though. We have a lot of ways to get momentum back. So, although it sucks that we misplayed there, it's okay. It's just misplays like that cost you games sometimes. And I would hate for that misplay to lose me the game. I don't see any Scarfers on this team, which is a huge relief. That's a huge relief. We see Specs, Chandelier, we see Life Orb, Excadrill, Leftovers, Gigalith, I think it was a Leftovers, Melodic. We haven't yet to see the Reuniclus. And I would not be surprised if maybe we saw the Reuniclus here. It would be interesting to see if maybe it's a Calm Mind variant. Because at this point, Reuniclus may do some decent amount of damage. Okay, so we just see the Reuniclus, and we're probably going to see a Toxic here. I think we just see a Toxic here. He doesn't know we have the Endeavor. I really feel like we're just gonna see a Toxic here. Scald is not gonna do anything at all to this guy. I just can't imagine seeing anything. I wish I had Fortress still alive to do a slow bolt switch. Toxic or Scald. Tell you what, we're going to send out Ninetales here. We do see the recover. Does Gigalith come out here? He has sent out Chandelure on this thing every single time. Every single time. And it's huge for us to get the Aurora Veil up. Here's the thing. I go for Aurora Veil, and if he does send in Gigalith, I just send in Mew. And a Mew can absorb anything. So let's just go for the Aurora Veil. And if he toxics us, that's fine. I just won't use Ninetales often, especially as an attacker, because I'll have a timer on me. I just really think that we're going to see Gigalith come out here. He sent Chandelure in twice on Ninetales. I don't really get it, but now we see Reuniclus. And that's very interesting. I'm just going to go for the Toxic here. I'm just going to go for the Toxic. And now we will have, hopefully, both of his walls on a timer, which is huge for us. I mean, that's huge. Unfortunately, my special wall in Politoed is getting worn down. This thing has a decent special defense. Not terrible by any means. I don't know what we see here. I'm not sure what we see. I really, really expected the Gigalith to come out there. The nice thing is that with this Aurora Veil up, it does help our tankier mons be more tanky. So that's great. Another nice thing is Excadrill is in HP ground range. And now we've gotten a Toxic off on the Gigalith, which is pretty huge. That's pretty huge. 261. Let's just see how much a Moonblast would do. Just to see if it's worth it at all. But that stand up, I just don't see that being a possibility, honestly. 16 to 22% if he's fully invested in special defense. 22 to 26. Stone Edge. We know he doesn't have Stone Edge. He has Rock Slide. And Rock Slide is going to do about, it's going to do a lot. Especially for what we're trying to keep Ninetales around for. It's going to do a lot. So we just want to go into Mutility here. And he may get the rocks up. And, you know, if he does, so be it. But he can't really hurt me underneath this veil. It does miss the Toxic. So that's unfortunate for him. And I just wonder now if going for the U-turn is the best play. And I think it is. I think the U-turn is the best play here. On the other hand, the only reason U-turn would not be a good play here is if he does not change out. You know what? I have Trevor to come in. Actually, I don't really want to send in Trevor, do I? It's probably better not to do that. If he switches out, we can just maybe knock something off. He doesn't switch out. He's going for the rock slide. We made the right call there. We made the right call. If we U-turn now, let me think about this. If we U-turn now, he goes down. We have to send somebody out. He keeps this thing around again, right? He says, I have to have Gigalith around to win this match. I have to set up Sandstorm one more time to win this match. We U-turn. He withdraws Gigalith here because he knows his Excadrill has to have that sand up. Has to have that sand up for him to win this match. There's no doubt about it. He withdraws Gigalith right here. He withdraws Gigalith. He sends either Melodic or Reuniclus in to take whatever. He sends probably Melodic in because Melodic has a Toxic on him. Or not. Okay, so this is interesting. The sand is up. Sand is up. What we have to do at this point is send out Trevor to get rid of the sand. So he's not any faster. If he knocks Trevor out, it's not a big deal. We get rid of the sand. And now we go back into Mew. Or we scald. No. He switches again. He has to switch again because he knows I'm underneath this veil and there's a chance that he might knock us out. Let me just calculate though. He has to switch again though. I'm almost positive. Earthquake does 42% max. No, he can't risk it. He cannot risk it. But I can't risk making too big of a play right here. I scald. And I knock out the Excadrill. Yep, that was the right play. We have to be extremely, extremely careful with these walls. He's definitely going to be feeling some pressure here. He's lost some really big attackers. He does have Chandelure still. Chandelure can actually come out now and put a little bit of pressure on me. But honestly, it doesn't put that much. I can just let Trevor go down. That's what I thought. I'm a defensive Mew, so Shadow Ball actually does quite a bit to me. I gotta make sure I do not screw this up. I'm in a position to win this game, and we need this win, and we cannot screw it up. So a Mew, and this is a Specs Chandelure. Let's remember that. This is a Specs Chandelure. Shadow Ball is going to do 62%, and he's going to be faster than us. That means that we almost guaranteed, well, actually, is that with the Aurora Veil up? Yes. So without Aurora Veil up, this thing knocks out our Mew. Let's see how well Ninetales takes it. It doesn't take a Fire Blast. It takes about everything else. That's okay. Let's knock off. I think knock off knocks this thing out. The only thing is we cannot overpredict. We can't overpredict at all. Although we could U-turn and maybe Thunderbolt. That's an idea. But let's just see what we're dealing with the Chandelure. Knock off 75 to 89. So we can't. Oh man. Why is that doing so little? Why is that doing so little? I think if he calcs us, he knows that he can live the hit. Which is really scary. Why is that doing so little? Is there a reason? I do not feel like this thing is that bulky. I'm just trying to figure out why this thing is living either a knockoff or be a drill run fairly well for Mega Beedrill. Because I have Beedrill in here, not Mega Beedrill. Guys, I was like, thought I was going crazy for a second. Like, there's no way, bro, that you're living a knockoff. There's no way. There was just no way. There was no way it was happening. I was so confused for a second. So confused. Why were my calcs saying my Mega Beedrill didn't take out a Chandelure with knockout or drill run? But it all makes sense now. It's calcing for a regular Beedrill. I'm gonna be honest though, that Chandelure is scary. That Chandelure is extremely scary. Okay. We're faster than this thing. We could get the Aurora Veil up one more time. But how important really is it at this point? Can Coco come in and get a kill in Electric Terrain? That's going to be the real question here. Minimum. Tapu Koko can come in here and get this kill. 100%, no doubt about it, can come in and pick up this kill. I'm going to be faster because he has Specs, and we know he has Specs. And so we are going to Thunderbolt. The Reuniclus is going to come in. It's going to absorb that hit. It's going to do maybe 25% to it. He is not letting his chandelier go down because he knows for a fact that if he can get some toxic damage off, this thing can come in and sweep me. And he knows that. This thing gets withdrawn. Reuniclus comes out. How much does the Vault Switch do here? 64 to 76. Vault Switch may be the play. And he's scarfed. He's scarfed, guys. I don't get it. I don't get it. I calc'd. Calc'd for the Shadow Ball. $284. I cannot believe you scarfed. I think this thing beats me. I think this thing straight up just beats me. I feel like we played really well. I calc'd something earlier and it said, wow. Wow, wow, wow. That's incredible. I cannot believe we played as well as we did, and the chandelier comes in and gets the win. We can't beat it. There's no way we can beat it. I don't have anything to beat the chandelier. But if he stays in and misses a fire blast, there's no way he chances that. There's no way he chances that. We're U-turning. There's no way he chances A, me being 427, or B, him missing a fire blast. I just don't believe he does that. But he might. He might. I don't know. He may calc. Okay. We couldn't send out Ninetales there because he's just going to send out Chandelier and Fire Blast. Oh, good game, Tar Heel. Good game. Cannot believe it was a scarf. I cannot believe it was a scarf. I don't know what I calc'd wrong. I had the... Uh, Shadow Ball knocks me out. Shadow Ball completely, utterly knocks me out. I'm gonna hope he hits me with the Fire Blast here. Gotta think, is there any way out of this? Is there any way out of this? Play here is knockoff. I'm going to click knockoff. I got to click knockoff. And unfortunately, this Shadow Ball that's scarfed. Hold on now. Hold on. Hold on. This thing is scarfed. It is not. So Fire Blast is actually the play to make the knockout. I've got to click knockoff. Holy moly. Holy moly. Oh my gosh. Now, that doesn't mean anything. But what it does mean, is I think we have the speed to recover. I think we have the speed on Mew to recover on Reuniclus. Oh. That's some crazy stuff, guys. That's some crazy stuff. And if he didn't get that special defense drop, we'd be in really good shape right now. I really, truly believe we would be in really good shape right now. Now, I have to deal with two walls. At least one has toxic on it. And we have to decide. The good news is we still have Ninetales alive. And Ninetales has Toxic on it. That was incredible. That was incredible. I don't know what the chances of me knocking him out with Knockout were. Let's just take a look at it. Knock off. It says I do 39 to 46%. And I did 66.3. Oh, okay. I'm calculating without an item. Just for argument's sake. He was Scarf. It does 59 to 69. It was a high roll. It was a higher roll, but it was in range. It was definitely within range. Now, here's the thing. This thing goes for the Toxic here, I think. There's no reason that we're not faster. 287. We're not faster. But 236... 287, is he going to invest in speed in this thing? No, I don't think so. Yeah. He's gonna Toxic. He's gonna Scald. Wow. We send this thing out, take the toxic. Yeah. Yep. That's what we gotta do. Send up the Aurora Veil. And now we have Freeze Dry. And we gotta hope that Freeze Dry kills this thing. It's not gonna kill that thing. It's not gonna kill that thing. So that is unfortunate. What speed is he? 174. Toxic? How much did that last poison do? It doesn't say. We gotta get a toxic off on this thing if we're gonna win this battle. Okay. How much does a knockoff do here to a Uniclus versus a U-turn? And let's remember that we are actually 252 adamant. Which almost bit us in the butt. It almost bit us in the butt. Knockoff is going to do an incredible amount. Oh wait, that's still the Chandler. So mm-hmm. Let's look at let's look at Reuniclus, which is a lot fatter. A lot fatter. Guys, I think I'm gonna lose to these walls. I think I'm gonna lose to these walls. U-turn's definitely the play. How much am I gonna take from like a shadow ball or something with Aurora Veil up? Not much, huh? Yeah, not much at all. Do I have at least 20% to spare? 26. Oh, I knocked out the Reuniclus. Holy moly. I'm just going to soft boil. Melodic. Mega Beedrill, 252 adamant. Poison Jab does minimum 45%. And he does a max of 22.5% to me. I should have this, right? He has no leftovers. I can just soft boil. There should be no reason that he should be able to get this. Guys, we worked hard for this if we get this win. We worked really, really hard. Oh, he's just gonna let himself go down. Guys, we should have lost that match. If you had known my Beedrill was not outspeeding his Chandelure, that match would have been lost and we had been toast. Let me wish this guy a good game. Good game, man. That was an incredible match. Because it was, guys. One of the best matches I've ever had. It was down to the wire. It was incredible. Great, great, great battle, Tar Heel. That was a lot of fun. I can't believe we came out with a 2-0 win on that. We kept Beedrill alive. We kept Mew alive. Guys, if you would have known that our Beedrill, if you would have known our Beedrill was 386 or 389 in speed and that his Chandelure outsped me by 50 points almost, it was game over. It was game over, guys. It was game over. If he preserved the Chandelure, it was game over. I calc'd incorrectly somewhere along the line. I calc'd it to be specs. It was not specs. It was scarfed. That thing could have came out and just scraped my team away. But Mew came through. He got a knockoff on the Chandelure. Knocked him out. And guys, we came out with a 2-0 victory. And it puts us tied for first place in the division. The Beedrills are back in action. We're here to make a statement this season. We're going to the playoffs, and we're not going only to the playoffs. We're going as the number one seed in our division. Guys, it's been a great, great battle. I'm so glad that you came here to watch it. Make sure you leave that like, you comment below, and subscribe to the channel. I think we're up to like 128 subscribers now, somewhere around there. And I really, really appreciate your support. I'm going to go celebrate this win with a good night's sleep, 8 hours hopefully. I'll see you next week. We got a really, really tough stretch ahead of us, but I know we can do it. I know we can do it. The Beedrills have a team that you do not want to mess with. We will volt switch, U-turn all over you if you're not prepared. Guys, I'm excited. I'm excited. But I'll see you next week, guys. Peace.